Alright, welcome to part 3 of my CNC router build. So today, we are going to be installing the X-axis, and we're going to put some new bearings on. Alright, so here's all of our 3D printed parts. So these are new ball bearing brackets for the Y-axis. I believe I'm going to install these just to make sure I have all the brackets square to the pieces of wood. And this will allow us to have our Y-axis perfectly straight on each end. And these are for our X-axis. These will be aluminum supports or mounting brackets. So we're going to have the tube mounted in here and in here. And this will screw onto our gantry. And right here is our ball bearing for our X-axis. So the ball bearings will go in like this. They're going to go in here as well. And I'm going to test that next. At this point, I realized this new bearing looks really well on aluminum tubing. Now I'm removing the old 2x4 from the old gantry, and I install my 3D printed brackets for the aluminum tubing. Now I install the aluminum tubing and remount my gantry. Then I screw the gantry into my new Y-axis bearings. Now I screw in the aluminum tubing to the plastic bracket to ensure there's no wobble between the two. Alright, so at this point, I used some threaded rods to put our linear bearing together, and this came out really nice. It flows nice. I can even adjust the tension on it with these nuts up here, but overall, I'm really happy with the result. I do want to know, I printed this at 100% infill, and it took about like 10 hours, so this was a really long print, but it came out nice. It was well worth it, because I was having a real big problem on my X-axis, but this solved it, so I highly recommend this to anybody that is doing it. So now we're going to remount our Z-axis, and then we'll put in our stepper motors. I mount a scrap 1x4 to serve as a piece of wood I can screw my Z-axis into. Then I drilled large holes into my Z-axis base to make room for the bolts and nuts sticking out from the 1x4. The easiest way to mount the linear bearings is to have a rod and two linear bearings, then I screw the linear bearings in place with them. At this point, it seems like my Z-axis works very well. I use the largest hole saw I have to drill out a large hole that can fit my router. At this point, my router mount is complete. I ended up screwing my Z-axis to that scrap 1x4, and I also used a large square to ensure that the Z-axis is parallel to the table. Alright, so I finished redoing the X-axis and the Z-axis. Overall, it came out absolutely awesome. So basically, here's our X-axis. I can move it very nicely. We have our Y right here as well. That moves nicely as well. I have the Z-axis. I have the kit, so that should work perfectly fine. And I also have it clamped in so it doesn't fall down. But overall, this came out really good. Now we just have to put in our stepper motors, and then we should be good to go. I bolted the Y-axis stepper motors into the square knockouts I made into the gantry. Then I screwed my Z-axis stepper motor into a custom wooden mounting bracket. Then I cut out 6 pieces of 1x6 for my belt holders. Then I used my router to make some slots in the wood. Now I use a screw and a washer to mount and tighten one end of the belt. Then I screw the belt into the 3D printed belt tensioner, and I tension the belt by screwing in the bolt. Now I screw my 3D printed belt tensioners. Then I screw my X-axis stepper motor using 4-inch screws. Alright, so before I go on any further, I want to say that I put this 2x4 back in because our gantry was getting a bit wobbly when I pushed it side to side. So I put 3 screws in here, here, and here. And I did that on the other side as well. And overall, this really snugged it up very nicely. There is little to no wobble on our gantry now, and this came out really nice. Alright, so at this point in the build, I mounted the belt system today and the stepper motor. So overall, the belt system and the stepper motors mounted very nicely. They were very tricky at first, but after fooling around and tinkering with it, I definitely got it and came out pretty nice. I'm very pleased. Alright, this concludes part 3 of my CNC router build. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.